Hello, and welcome to another segment of the HBM series where we talk about healthcare, business, and music. My name is Anita, and in this segment, we'll be talking about 5 steps to run a medical practice effectively and a host of other things. We would like to say congratulations to physicians who just opened your practice. Congratulations to any physicians or new grads around the world who just opened your practice. Now that you have opened your practice, here are some few things to keep in mind. Stay tuned and enjoy. Changes in regulation. This cannot be stressed enough because the healthcare industry is very regulated and is constantly changing from day to day. So everything regarding what providers do changes from time to time. And so small practices who don't have a legal attorney may find it difficult to follow requirements. And so therefore, it's important that practices ensure that they're in compliance. And so their number one priority should be hiring a consultant who understands laws surrounding medical practice. Okay, and the consultant will advise them about, you know, legal laws and things about fraud. And actually, they should take a whole course when it comes to things about fraud, because of course, we only need to make business profit. And so some practices who don't, you know, who want to cut costs, and everybody does, of course, may do things that they don't know they're doing wrong and end up, you know, paying huge fines for that because they're trying to cut costs. So the next aspect that medical practices should keep in mind, or health professionals who are opening a medical practice should keep in mind, is marketing. Of course, marketing is very vital in our everyday to day life, in any kind of business, especially healthcare, because healthcare is a patient caring business. And so practices need to know how to sell themselves. Different ways of doing marketing include radio stations, connecting with radio stations, putting your names in billboards, buses, train stations, and things of that nature. Everything that is in compliance, anything that you know within the confines of what you can do, you should do when it comes to marketing, if you can afford it, of course. And you know, you don't have to spend enough money to do marketing, really. A lot of people don't know that, but it is important, you know, putting your seminars out there and things like that. Now, benefits of marketing include it increases visibility, like explained before. Putting your names on billboards, radio stations, and all that increases your visibility. And when we say that, it lets people know who you are, it lets people know what you stand for, it lets people know what you do, and it develops a lasting relationship with your audience. And so, you know, when people start to see your name and your posters and stuff, it sticks. And so, you know, they want to know what you do, especially if you're interested, if it's something that would benefit them, if it's something that they want to be part of, definitely. And it improves your brand awareness. It creates loyalty and trust with current customers and prospective customers. It helps health practices build authority and credibility. It widens your market. It provides gainful employment opportunities. And people who, for example, see a poster about a certain place or a certain healthcare practice, oh, let me see what they do, blah, 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 they're looking for a job, and then they get a job. A doctor might see the new grad or somebody who wants to do an internship or something of that nature. So it does help with, it provides gainful employment opportunities. It stabilizes economic conditions, and it provides satisfaction of even more. It also acts as a basis for making decisions. So, considering construction needs must also be considered. You want to consider your construction needs as early as possible so it does not affect your opening date and things of that nature. And so, continuing from considering construction needs, having said that in the previous slide, that, you know, construction needs must be considered as early as possible so it does not affect your opening dates. You have to look at the location, you have to evaluate your location, regardless of where you are. If you're in Africa, they have things like hormonal issues when it comes to, like, if you built your practice, so you need to know that there's no hormonal issues. When it comes to, if you're in the US or any parts of the world where, you know, you just get your location, you pay for it, and you don't have any issues with that, and you just need to evaluate the building, you know that there is no mold issue and all that before you start to put your equipment and you start to bring in an interior decorator to help you assess your building and all that. So it's important to consider construction needs long before equipment are being purchased.
standards.
The next aspect we'll be talking about is the meaningful use of standards. Now, we cannot overemphasize this or over talk about this because the healthcare world is currently going through a period of digitization. Most healthcare organizations use electronic medical records, also known as the EMR, and practice management systems. Medical practices must ensure that their EMR partners can meet the demands that allow them to function up to standard. And so you have to make sure that whoever your EMR partner is, they can meet the demands that allows you to function up to standard and up to par, because things are constantly changing. So you need to be sure that you guys are, you know, working up to standards and things of that nature. Remember, we talked about the fact that if EMRs and things that are not in sync, there's some things you may not qualify for. There's some benefits the government gives or things like that, that if some certain things are not up to standard, you're not going to get it. And so this ends the aspect of, you know, a couple of other things that we wanted you guys to be able to consider while you open your practice, additional consideration tips. Our next part of the segment is going to be talking about 5 steps to run your medical practice on a day-to-day basis. Stay tuned and enjoy. 5 steps to run your medical practice on a day-to-day basis. Come with me. Number one, being technology savvy. Medical practices need to be technology savvy because this helps them to eliminate errors, improve patient outcomes. It also helps them with tasks such as appointments, reminders, newsletters, and generally saves time. Every staff in the practice also needs to be trained with any new equipment. Actually, all staff, if there is new equipment, new technology that's going to help them with the practice that they're going to be using on a constant basis, everybody needs to be retrained. They have to block off like maybe a lunch hour or something so that everybody needs to be trained. Number two, using online scheduling tools. Real-time online scheduling, digital scheduling tools allow patients to schedule appointments on their own. This helps cut back on phone time wasted scheduling and rescheduling appointments. Using automated newsletters also helps medical practices communicate with their patients effectively. So in running a medical practice effectively on a day-to-day basis, it's important to look ahead. So getting prepared, knowing what materials need to be stocked in place for the day's activities. I mean, instilling it in health professionals, be it like, you know, the nurses, doctors, or those who works in the practice, to make sure that if it's their card, if it's whatever they use, they should make sure that, you know, it's stocked and in place, which helps the practice, so helps everything to run effectively. It's also important to review your to-do list, like everything that you need to do. You need to evaluate and rank appointments, procedures, and meetings in order of priority. It's also important to follow schedule religiously and work not to get distracted by less important work. So of course, it's true that every day you're not just going to follow things religiously. Things come up, things crop up, but it's important to make sure that you're not getting distracted by less important work, because whether we like it or not, there's more important work and there's less important work in anything. So that's why things need to be, you know, put in order of priority and scheduled correctly so that your practice runs effectively. Our final point when it comes to running a medical practice on a day-to-day basis is scrutinizing your scheduling calendar. And so scheduling can have a huge impact on efficiency and profitability, and so that's with any business, especially the medical practice. In medical practice, every minute counts, and so it's important to take a patient's demographics into consideration. For example, a patient who lives an hour away has an appointment at 8:30 and tends to show up at 8:15. Then staff and every healthcare professional attending to this patient should arrive at 8 a.m. In conclusion, running a practice according to acceptable guidelines improves morale and increases profitability. Yes, health practices must set the expectations of efficiency with all staff members by having established routine and daily stand-ups, which result in a more structured and organized environment with less stress. Everyone that has watched this movie or this video can say that it's been a refresher for some. It's been a refresher for others. They've learned something. I'm confident that at least you've learned something. Now, please tell your friend Tell your friend to tell their friend about the HBM series. Thank you so much for stopping by today. We expect to see you the next time. We appreciate you coming by here. Thank you. Bye for now. Please take care.
For business inquiries, please contact us at hbmseries@gmail.com. Our Facebook page is HBM Series. Our LinkedIn page is Anita E. Orisha Jaffo. And our Instagram page is BMOMA. So BMOMMAA. Thank you so much. Have a great week.